source charge. Now, since it's a charge, so it will produce, it will have some effect around it, right? Because it's a charge, it will have an electrical effect around it, right? Electrical effect means some electrical force will exist around the charge. And who can experience that force? Only another charge can experience that force. If some another charge is coming in this region, that will only can experience that force. If you bring something which is neutral thing here, it will not experience the force. Okay, understand? So that means if you want to bring another charge from outside to a particular location here, then for that thing, whenever you try to come in this region, okay, then you will experience some repelling force, because this is also positive, and suppose source charge is also positive, you will experience some repelling force, and you need to do some work against this repelling force. And work done per unit charge, that is called as the value of electric potential, at that point P. Okay, at that point P, and this potential has developed basically due to this source charge. Okay, so in fact, now, if you want to bring, so that you have to calculate this work. Work is nothing but force into displacement. If you remember, upon charge. Now, the problem here is that the force is not constant. As I told you last class, force is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. The source charge into the test charge is unit charge. And distance between them, R square. Now, this R is variable. Okay, even if you are moving in the same direction, that R is variable, because as you are continuously moving, R is continuously decreasing. So since R is variable, therefore force is variable, okay? And since the force is variable, you cannot put one value over here and solve this problem. That is the question, okay? That is the problem in this derivation, okay? Got it? Up to this is clear, okay now. So what we need to do is that we will do one thing. We will move the charge only for the small distance. We'll move the charge for a small distance dr. Dr means, d means a small change. Dr. So the distance is such a small distance that during this duration, the force remains constant for that duration. Okay. So for the duration, that r is not at all changing. That is so small, this one, that 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q into 1 by R square. Now you can say this R is the distance. This, now you call it, this is R plus DR, okay? And this is R. So almost both are equal. So we just took at R, okay? We just took as R. It's only, we can say that at R and R plus DR, both the places force is same. We are not bothered, okay? So that is the work done equal to this much, okay? Work done is force into displacement. Now this is a small work done. So we are writing it as dw. D means small. So small work done is equal to the small force, or sorry, the force, whatever the force, into the small displacement. Okay. This force is the force, whatever is the force, but this displacement is the small displacement. Okay. So the dw is equal to fdr. This is the standard equation. We have to solve our derivation. We have to do our derivation based on this equation. Dw equal to fdr. Okay. So till now what we have discussed, that there is a source charge Q and we have moved our test charge by small distance, and that small distance is dr, and this is r, and this is r plus dr, and our small work done for moving the unit charge by small distance dr is given by this thing, and force is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught by Coulomb's law, Q into 1 by R square into dr. As I told you, this is the formula for the small work done. Now, what we need to do is, we have to do this activity again and again and again and again and again, and do it several lakhs of times to cover all the small dr distance. And basically, we have to summation we have to do for this all the small work done. For each dr, we need to do the summation. Summation is the symbol. This is called the sigma symbol. Summation of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q dot 1 upon r square dr. We have to repeat this analysis from this point till this point. Basically, that the small r is basically changing from, basically it is going, coming from infinity. It was at infinity. The r value was infinity. And finally, the r value is becoming zero. So our small r is changing from infinity to small r is changing for zero. For each and every small interval from infinity to zero, we need to do this summation. Okay. So basically our derivation is like this. dw is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q into 1 by small r square into dr. We are doing the summation on the left side as well as the summation on the right side, because we are going to do this activity again and again for each dr from r equal to infinity to r equal to zero. Okay, now the problem is that when you are doing this kind of activity for each small dr, you will tell, one of you will tell that, maybe Tarika tells that I will take 1 lakh intervals. Okay. And maybe that Saranya will tell that I will take 1 crore intervals, like that. Okay. So both of you are having different, because the smaller the interval you take, the more accurate you are. Why you are more accurate if you take the smaller interval? Because we are having some assumption here. What is the assumption? The assumption is that at r and r plus dr locations, for both the location, this dr distance, we are taking a constant value of the force at that location. We are taking only r square. Okay, we are assuming that force is constant, but actually the force is variable. Force is inversely proportional to r square. Force is changing, but more smaller this interval dr, the more accurate your calculation will be. So she is more accurate as compared to her. So therefore, we want the intervals to be so small that when you do that kind of thing, that interval becomes so small, the things start looking like continuous. From discretization, it seems to be continuous. Like when you climb very small steps, very, very small steps, and the small steps become even smaller, the steps become even smaller, then what happens, that it looks like a slope, and it looks like a slope, and it looks like this. Okay. Otherwise it looks like a small steps. Okay. So when the small steps, when the discrete things become continuous, when the discrete things become continuous, when the number of steps are so high that you cannot even differentiate between the steps, then the summation becomes the integration. Then the summation becomes what? Summation becomes what? The type of summation becomes integration. Discretization is converted into integration. And for integration, there is a symbol, and that symbol is a snake symbol. This is the symbol for integration. Integration of dw is equal to, the summation has become the integration of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q into 1 by r square into dr. And this is called the lower limit of integration, r equal to 0. This is called the upper limit of, or lower limit is r equal to infinity, and upper limit is r equal to 0. Are you understanding this? So understood up to that integration part. What is integration? Means summation. When you are converting discrete things into continuous things in order to achieve accuracy, that is called as integration. Okay, integration is a mathematical tool to do the summations in such a manner that discretized things become continuous. Okay. Now what will happen is that when you start integrating, dw is equal to integration f dot dr. Okay, f dr means whatever f is, what, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q dot 1 by r square into dr. Okay, then I will tell you the formula of integration. Integration of, basically we integrate some function of x with respect to x. We pronounce it as integration of f of x with respect to x. With respect to x means this is with respect to x. We call it as with respect to x. And this is what we call it as, the function f of x, which we are integrating. And this is called integral symbol. Now I'll just explain you what is integration. Imagine that this is f of x and this is x. Okay. This is f of x means this is y. Suppose y is equal to x square. Y is equal to x square looks like this. This is the curve. Okay. suppose I ask you what is the area under this curve, what is the area under this curve, you will tell, sir, this is the area under this curve. I will ask you, can you calculate this area? Can you calculate this area? Then you will tell, sir, it is very difficult. Why it is very difficult? Because this kind of curve things, you don't know any formula, no formula for this type of things, right? So in that case, you will take the help from integration. Take the help from where? From integration. What kind of thing you will do? You will do one thing. You will come with an idea. What idea you will come with? Sir, what I will do is, sir, I will divide this entire area. Sir, I will divide this entire area into small, small rectangles, sir. I will divide this entire area into small, small rectangles, sir. So what will happen by dividing in small, small rectangle? I will calculate the area of one rectangle. Suppose this is the small interval dx. This is dx is the small interval. D means change, actually. D means change, small change. Very small change is called D. D means, dx means x2 minus x1 only basically, but very small difference, okay? This is suppose x2 and this is x1, that is called dx, okay? So I am talking d means delta x only. Delta x, when delta become very small, it becomes d, okay? So this is dx and I am talking about, we are doing one approximation here. We are assuming that it's a rectangle, but it is not a rectangle actually. It is not a rectangle because there is some curve portion here. Is it or not? There is a curve portion here. It is like this, okay? It is like this. So basically this is like a rectangle. This is also rectangular, but this, the top portion, there is a difference between them. There is a difference between these two points and it's not a rectangle, but we are assuming it's a rectangle. This is a kind of assumption. And one more thing, remember. So basically the small area dA of the small rectangle will be the height into the width. The height is y because this point will be x comma y. So the height will be y and the width will be dx. So dA will be y dot dx, y into length into breadth, length into breadth. Now you want to calculate the complete area. So basically you have to do this activity again and again for all the rectangles in between these two limits from here to here. Okay. But then you start fighting with each other that I want to make this rectangle as thin as possible, because if you make the rectangle as thin as possible, this, the approximation which you are doing, this curve part, the approximation will become smaller and smaller and your answer will become more and more accurate. Okay. Wherever you want to make your answer accurate, you will convert the, you can convert the sigma symbol into integral symbol. So integral of dA will become integral of y dot dx. Now integral dA will become the total area A is equal to integral of y dot dx. Understood or not understood? Now you remember this curve. What is this curve? Y equal to x square. Na? The curve was what? Y equal to x square. So finally, your answer will be area equal to integral of, instead of y, what you have to write? X square dx. X square dx. Now you should have a mathematical formula to calculate integral y dot dx, area equal to integral x square dot x square dx. There is a formula. The formula says integration of x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So your answer will be x cube by 3, n plus 1 by n plus 1. And from where to where you are integrating, suppose you are integrating from x equal to 0 to x equal to 5 meters. Suppose your graph was from x equal to 0 to x equal to 5 meters. So this is called lower limit and upper limit. After solving, you have to put the value. This is the method. So 5 cube by 3 minus 0 cube by 3, just a method of solving it. And this becomes 125 by 3 meter square is the area under this curve. Within seconds, I am able to calculate the area under the curve in front of you with the help of the tool, which is called as what? This tool is called what? This tool is called as integration. Are you getting it? What is integration? Very good. I just repeat it once more. Basically, integration is nothing but is basically used for finding the area under the curves. For finding the area under the curves. The difficult curve. Suppose you have a special curve, x and y. Suppose y equal to x cube. Now this curve y equal to x cube means you will plot that curve. You know how to plot the curve, right? X and y, x equal to 0, y equal to 0, x equal to 1, y equal to x equal to 2, y equal to 8, x equal to 3, y equal to 27. If you plot it, it will look like this one. It is a very dangerous type of curve. And suppose you want to calculate the area under this curve from this limit to this limit, suppose x equal to 0 to x equal to 3 meters, you want to calculate, then what you need to do is you have to run one strip. You have to make a strip like this. That is strip width is dx and this height is y, which is a variable height. It's continuously changing height. So basically what you have to do, the area of the small rectangle dA is equal to length into breadth. The length is height is y and the breadth is dx. And then what you have to do is you have to do this activity again and again so that you are covering entire area. And finally, this will become capital A and this will become integral dA, integral y dot dx, because you want the rectangles to be so small that discretized thing become continuous. Integration of x cube dx, because y is x cube, you have to put this in terms of x cube. And for that, I told you the formula x power 4 by 4. And what is the lower limit is 0 and higher limit is 3. So you have to put the lower limit and higher limit in this integral. So final answer will be 3 power 4 by 4 minus 0 power 4 by 4. So final answer will be 81 by 4 meter square. Within seconds, I have calculated area under this cubic curve in front of you using the tool called as integration tool. Okay.